Good evening. Good evening, Sameek. Hi. Good evening, everybody. We're just waiting to get Dr. Rishikesh online. He should be coming online anytime now. I've just seen his request come through already. Yeah, I think just a couple more seconds. He should be coming online anytime now. Can you all hear me? If you can, just give me a quick thumbs up just to say that I'm audible.
Hello.
Hello. Hello, is that Dr. Rishikesh?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, I can barely hear you. I can just hear you and I can't see you either. Anjali, you can hear me, right? Okay, that's a thumbs up. So those who have come online can hear me. But Dr. Rishikesh, we're not able to hear you at all. Do you want to log in again? Do you want to try doing that? Yeah, sometimes it could be the network too. I seem to have full network though. Yeah, great. Thanks, Anjali. Thanks for confirming that you can hear me. I think there seems to be some network issues at Dr. Rishikesh's end. Well, he's just sent me a request yet again. I'm just going to try and get him online. Please bear with me. It says connecting. Can you hear me, Dr. Rishikesh? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, but I think
yeah, you can hear me, but I think yeah, something's up with the video. Unfortunately, I can't see you either. But are you able to see me? Can you hear me? I hope it's not one of those days when the network is just giving up on us. Maybe not. Yeah, because I seem to have full network. And Anjali, you can see me too, right? Anjali, can you see me as well? Hi, Akshita. Hi, guys. I just don't know if it's a network issue that we are facing. Dr. Rishikesh has yet again sent me an invite, so let me just quickly accept that and see if we could bring him online. Unfortunately, I think Instagram seems to be playing up very frequently now. Not sure if it's the weekend rush or if it's just network issues. Please bear with us. We're just gonna keep trying this couple more minutes. Can you hear me, Dr. Rishikesh? Hello? Can you hear me? Because I'm just not able to see you at all. There's absolutely no video. Oh yeah, there you go. Okay, now I can see you. Are you able to see me?
One second.
Yeah, I can see you. Are you able to
see
me?
Yeah, hi.
Yes, you can. Yes, okay. Have you kind of logged in from your iPad or are you on your phone? I presume
it's
you are
phone.
On your phone, right? It's on phone. Yeah, because yeah, definitely it has to be on the phone. Okay, great. Okay, finally we've got you online. A very good evening to all our all those who have joined us online, and we'd like to welcome Dr. Rishikesh, who is the Chief Ayurvedic Consultant at NAD Wellness in Kundli, Haryana. Now, Dr. Rishikesh is an MS in Shalya Tantra, which is Ayurvedic surgery from SSR Ayurvedic Medical College and Hospital. He's also a fifth generation Ayurvedic doctor. His family runs and owns an Ayurvedic hospital in Kerala, which specializes in creating their in-house medicines. Dr. Rishikesh brings with him a clinical experience of over 10 years and specializes in Panchakarma, which is detoxification and sports rehabilitation. Now, this evening, we have a really, really interesting topic that we are going to be picking on with Dr. Rishikesh. We're going to be talking about doshas and how doshas can affect our eating habits, and how once, you know, cuisines can actually be customized to balance doshas. So a very warm welcome to you, Dr. Rishikesh. How are you doing today?
Namaste. Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Very well. Thank you. So, so we've just, you know, I've given out an introduction of yourself to those of, you know, our viewers today. So let's kind of start off with our topic of discussion, which I'm sure lots of people will find it extremely interesting. So to start with, can you explain to us what is the concept of doshas? Now, I know it. You have three doshas. You have the Vata, the Pitta, and the Kapha. And if you could just explain the whole concept of these doshas, please.
Yeah, sure. So first of all, we'll start with a sloka, because our Ayurveda, everything is written in sloka form.
Okay.
So it's like Vayu Pittan Kapachedi, Treyo Dosha Samasadaha, Vikrita Avikrita Deham, Khandide Vartendija. So that sloka means there are three doshas, that is Vata, Pitta, Kapha. Balance of the dosha, that means that is healthy, and any imbalance that is causing tridoshas will lead to diseases. So that is the main concept. Tridoshas, coming to the tridoshas, these are present in all over our body. So its body is completely made up of tridoshas. But some particular area, it is its main site. So like if we are dividing our body into three parts. So the parts above our chest. So that is a kapha region. And the region between our chest and the umbilicus, that is a pitta region. And the region below the umbilicus, that is a vata region. So coming to the person's life also, in the initial stage, like the childhood, kapha will be more. Coming to the middle age, that is pitta will be more. And to the old age, again, vata will be more.
Okay.
So in a day and night also, the kala like also will tell the first, second and the third kala in a day. So the first kala will be always in day also, night also, first kala will be always kapha, then again pitta, and the last part of the day or night is like vata. So while eating, again, coming to the eating and the digestion.
Sorry,
also,
can I quickly just stop you? I mean, you know, you just said it also depends on the age. So you mean to say the doshas in the body can change as you, you know, start growing older? Is that what it is?
Not like that actually. So basically our prakriti will be there, be changed. That will be there. But overall, in the presence of predominant doshas, dosha have slight changes always. So like in childhood, like kids and all, small kids and all, they will be more, kapha will be more in them. But coming to middle age, more pitta will be dominating, and old age, like I can, like vada will be more. So vada can be, it can be all related again to the modern means, like neurological related, nervous related things and all. So in the old age, like more vada symptoms will be more. So like neurological or nervous disorder, everything will be more in the. So this all based on our, again, prakriti won't be changing on some particular region, like throughout our life, the prakriti will be same only. In some like very rare cases, only few people, the prakriti also slight changes. That again in a controversy, it is slight changes will be there. Otherwise, prakriti will be same for all.
Okay, I get that. Okay.
And coming to the qualities. So each, like each doshas have some qualities. So vata, pitta, kapha, each have qualities. So vata qualities is like, it is dry always. Its nature is like, it is dry, it is light, it is rough actually. So these are, we cannot see like, it's vata is like this, so vata we cannot see. But seeing a person, if its body, if you are seeing it is rough, if it is dry, it is like dry, light, oily, means like not oily, mobile, it's like involuntary movements will be there. So these all are like vata symptoms. So then coming to pitta, pitta will be always very hot. It is sharp, it is liquid in form, it is spreading type, and it is oily in nature. And then kapha is always heavy in nature. It is heavy, it is slow in action, it is cool, it is smooth, it is soft, like that. So these are the qualities of tridoshas. So these are doshas. Then I'm coming to the prakriti. So prakriti is the body constitution. But this doshas, I'm just telling you, very, very, very brief, I'm telling you, because it's a vast subject.
I know. So in that I did some reading. I definitely did some reading about it. I mean, the subject is so vast that, yes, we definitely can't cover that in 1 hour. So we want to try and, you know, get the maximum information out to, you know, those who are online. So they just at least even understand what doshas are and how it can contribute to one's healthy eating. So that's what we're focusing on today. Yes. Correct. Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Sorry,
so coming to the prakriti. So prakriti, prakriti I was telling. Prakriti is again, it's a combination of doshas, tridoshas. So because of the combination, so we are having like an idea like he is supposed vata pitta or pitta kapha like that. So we will have the predetermination like how his physical, how his mental, how his emotional strength, how it is. So we will be having an idea for, especially for doctors, for diagnosis and for treatment, that is very much helpful. Understanding the prakriti first. So again this prakriti, how it form. So other factors are also there along with dosha, the predominant dosha. Along with that, the other factors like how about the ovum and the sperm, how during the formation of a fetus. So sperm, ovum, that is also a factor. Then the season, then the nature of the uterus. Then coming to the Mahabhudas, that is the prithvi, like different Bhudas like Vayu, Vada, Vayu, Agni, Jala. What is the predominant Mahabhuda? So that also is a factor. So ultimately the final predominant dosha at that time, that will determine the prakriti of that person.
So again, so I'm usually going to stop you there. So it's, sorry. So it's just not genetic. It could be environment based too.
It's genetic only during the, this all in the, like the formation of the fetus, that time it is, not like after birth. It is all.
So it's genetic, so, as well as depending on when the actual conception of, you know, a fetus happens. Correct. Okay. Got it.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
I get it. Now.
So that time, the that time, the season, the nature of the mother's uterus, everything is a factor in that. So that, the formation of that. And again, that time, what, again, mother's main thing, mother's diet and regimen, that also a factor in this. So she's having like more vata related or more kapha food items. These all have also some impact on this formation of prakriti. So usually the prakriti, we will tell like it's a combination of two doshas. Three doshas will be there in the body, but usually the two doshas, it's like three doshas equal. It is very rare to find the people with only okay, vata, pitta, kapha, equal person. That is very rare to find. So
Okay.
usually it's like a combination of vata, pitta, or pitta, kapha, or vata, kapha, like that is a combination.
Right.
So, yeah. So again, we can tell like doshas can be, the prakriti can be classified into two types. Sharirika prakriti, that is the physical constitution, and the manasika prakriti also there. So
Okay.
sharirika prakriti is a body composition that is again classified into seven types. So it's alone vataja, pittaja, kafaja, vata kafaja, vata pittaja, kapha vata, like that. It's and again the sannipaja, that is the three doshas. So like that seven
Okay.
will be there. And
Okay.
again the manasika prakriti like sattvika, rajasika, tamasika. So again sub classification are there, the 16 types are there under that also.
Oh
So
wow.
it's a detail.
Okay. Yeah, I know, as you said, the information is definitely very vast, but I think what we
Yes,
should
yes.
just focus is on the three doshas. Now,
Yeah.
I know, you know,
So,
people normally go through, sorry, go on.
yeah, so first, you do you know about your dosha? So what
Yeah,
dosha
I
you?
mean, I took a questionnaire just to understand what my dosha is, and I think I'm Pitta Vata concentrated. So now,
Okay.
depending on that, would you please, like, you know, tell me as to what
Yes,
you think
sure,
my
sure.
characteristics are, and you know, yeah.
Yeah, so based on you as an example, I will be explaining that.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so Pitta. So Pitta and Vata. So here also Pitta and Vata. So it's not like Vata Pitta. Pitta Vata we are telling. So Pitta properties will be more in you than Vata. That's why Pitta is
Okay.
highlighted first. We can always say,
Okay.
okay, both are there. So Vata Pitta also I can tell. No, it's Pitta is
Okay.
more in you. That's why Pitta Vata is
Ah,
coming.
so that's why it's Pitta Vata. Okay. Okay.
Pitta Vata. Yeah. So
Okay.
Pitta. So the normal. So the normal function of a Pitta is like it's responsible for the digestion, metabolism. Complexion, then feeling like a thirst, hunger, like courage, everything. These are the main response. Means Pitta is responsible for these things. And Vata. Vata means it's like all movements of the body. All movements in the body are because of Vata. So movement of
Okay.
blood in our body, movement of
Okay.
air, like respiration, movement of our hand, movement of our head. All the movements in our body because of Vata. So,
Okay.
so yours is like combination. So Pitta and Vata. So a Pitta Vata person. So how it will be? So a Pitta Vata person is always will be. If a characteristic wise, you are telling me, it's always will be powerful. Have the habit of debating.
Okay.
Quick in emotions. Yeah. So like quick in emotions of anger and also
Okay.
compassion. It's quick in
Okay.
action. So.
Okay.
They will be eating much because they will feel always hungry, and
Okay.
it's
Okay. But
one more thing
yeah,
is
but
that
that could be a
cannot eat.
combination because
Yeah,
Okay.
so they cannot skip the meals. That's the main thing. They cannot skip the
Yeah.
meals, and they will be
Okay, that's
feeling
very
thirsty
true. Yeah.
frequently. Yeah,
Okay.
so they will be feeling thirsty frequently, and they dislike like Pitta is like hot. It is always Pitta means hot temperature, everything by so Pitta. So they will be disliking heat more, and like perspire, they will be perspiring also. Perspiration also will be more, and they will be having difficulty in like sleeping. Means they want to sleep. They cannot skip the sleep also, and
Yeah.
some common disease condition also like more of the like Pitta Vata people will be having digestive related issues. So
Okay.
it's like. Yeah, so digestive related issues. Some people will be constipation will be there commonly, and some people will be diarrhea also. Then
Okay.
gastritis related.
Okay.
Then inflammatory conditions also. So these are
Okay.
common, and like migraine related issues. Then skin
Okay.
rashes, itchy skin. Like these are some symptoms. It's not like everyone have to get, but these are the common
Yeah.
disease.
Common
And yeah.
characteristics. Okay.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay. Great. I mean, thank you so much for, you know, telling me, you know, what my dosha is and what I could lean on to more. Now, going on to now, so how does one actually eat according to their doshas, Dr. Rishikesh?
Doshas.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So how does
So
one eat
same.
according to them? Yeah.
Yeah. So coming to again, same your dosha also, Pitta Vada, if I'm explain means. So it's
Yeah.
like Fiery Pitta will tell. So it should be cooled down first. So all the most of the things will be like cold properties we have to do. It's not like cold items we have to take, food items in cold. No, it's like normal temperature because it's combination of Vata also coming. If too much cold we are taking, Vata also will get aggravated. So it should be balanced to that. So Pitta
Okay.
Vata always it should be normal temperature. It should not be too hot also, not very
Okay,
cold
sorry, I'm
also.
just going to stop you there very quickly. I have this
Yeah.
habit of drinking only hot water. So are you saying
Okay.
that it could be detrimental?
Yeah, for you, I can tell that for you, best is room temperature. That is best.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
Because
so I
you have
should
to
avoid
balance
drinking
your.
hot water. Okay. Okay.
With, you can
Okay.
boil and cool water. That is like boiled and cold to like even loop, a maximum little lukewarm water you can have. It's not a too
Yeah,
hot
because no,
water you
because
should.
you know, in my profession, because I have to talk constantly because I teach, so I'm like typically
Okay.
teaching 6, 7, 8 hours a day. So because of that, just to kind of, you know, settle my throat, I
So,
tend to
yeah.
drink a lot of hot water consistently because that kind of helps me with my throat. So maybe, as you said, I should possibly try and, you know, drink water, you know, room temperature water or maybe cool
Yes,
water.
yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay,
It's not
great.
too
I mean,
cold,
that's
but
very
it should be
interesting.
normal. Yeah, normal temperature because Pitta should not get aggravated again. So Pitta should be
Okay.
balanced. So that's the concept
Okay.
in that. Then
Okay,
coming to
great.
fruits, fruit and yeah, fruits. So fruits means for your like Pitta Vata, people will be like sweet fruits. So whatever sweet that you can have, sweet fruits, I'm telling, sweet fruits you can tell.
Okay.
But store items, stored food like oranges, that is not recommended. But sweet, sweet mango, sweet papaya, sweet banana, these all are advised. But store like
Okay.
mangoes, like oranges, these are not advised.
Okay.
And
You
you
know, but
can
that is,
undry the food.
it is so true because it's so contradictory now to what I am doing because I love things that are sour. You know, acidic food. So I kind of really like food which is like even raw mangoes, for example, or anything sour is something that I actually crave for. So now there you go, because that can actually affect me. Yeah, I know, I completely understand what you're saying. Yeah.
Yes. So sore is especially for Pitta person, sore food items are not recommended at all.
Yeah.
So even like even one more thing is to reduce oil also, fat and salt items in if for
Okay.
a Pitta person. So Pitta Vata person, it's
Okay.
like combination. I'm telling Pitta Vata person.
Okay.
So dairy, another thing is the dairy products. So dairy products are recommended in a minimum, like not too much dairy products, but
Okay.
should avoid the sour culture like yogurt. Then
Oh,
again,
really?
cheese. These are
Okay.
not allowed. Yeah, but buttermilk
Oh,
is the
okay.
ideal for a person. Buttermilk is the ideal choice.
But buttermilks are also sour. So how would you categorize
So, but
that
it's
then?
maximum removing the fat and adding more water, and then with a little like this and all ginger. Then little, it's too much spicy. Also, it should not be because with the person, too much spicy also is not advised. So,
Okay. Okay.
maximum removing the fat items from that, adding more water. So the buttermilk is advised in a Pitta person. Pitta because Pitta
Okay.
Vata person, so it is advised. And also
Okay.
coming to vegetables, the vegetable items. So like bottle gourd, sweet potato, pumpkin, these are all advised in. And most of the vegetables are like Pitta passing. It is.
Okay. Okay.
And for
Okay.
cooking, yeah, and for cooking also, ghee and coconut oil is advised for a Pitta
Okay.
person.
Okay.
Yeah,
Okay,
and
great. I mean, that
yeah.
is so informative, Dr. Rishikesh. I mean, I definitely, yeah, I probably need to heed to all of these and maybe consult with you privately to see, you know, all the do's and don'ts. No, which is great, which is
And
great.
one,
Thank you so much.
yeah, okay. And you were telling you are having like a hot water you usually have, so it's
Yeah.
better that. If you can if put fennel seeds in that and boil that water you are drinking because that will help more in your digestion also.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. Thank you so much. And now moving on, I know I'm just a little conscious about the time because we started off a little late and you know the Insta chats kind of get disconnected in 1 hour. So, you know, currently, or say even in the recent past, there's been a lot of emphasis on seasonal eating. For instance, now there are fruits like watermelons and mangoes, which you find them even off season. You'll probably, walk into a restaurant during December and, you get to eat, like get to drink mango juice or watermelon juice. Now, what is your take on that? I mean, how important it is for an individual to stick to seasonal eating, because I think historically that's what our ancestors followed. And is that a good practice for us to kind of follow that?
Okay. So as per Ayurveda, only the seasonal fruits are advised. Only the seasonal fruits, what is going, that only it's advised. So nowadays it's like either using preservatives or with like defrosting and all, they are preserving this. So these preservatives are all, again, one more reason for other health issues also. So as per Ayurveda, recommended that only have the what is particularly available in that particular season, that should be taken.
Okay.
So I get it. Because in Ayurveda, like a season, so Ritu, we will tell Ritu. So this have major role, actually major role in the health of a person also, and the overall this environment also. So for that only it's framed like a Ritu Charya. In Ayurveda, it's mentioned Ritu Charya for each season. So like six seasons, we are telling Shishira, Vasanta, Grishma, like Sharat, Hemanda, and Varsha. So for each season, like Ritu Charya is mentioned in Ayurveda. So it is very helpful actually to follow, because we will be already, it is mentioned in the classic. So just to follow, so and what all things we should take care, that is, what are the do's and what are the don'ts. So we will be having a clear picture in that. So based on that, if we are following, so many, I can tell many, in many health issues, that will be very helpful. So the Ritu Charya have a major role in our life also, because each season have different properties. So some food items we should take, one some food items we should not take, some activities we should do, that which we should not do, that is there mentioned. Okay. So another major thing is one Ritu Sandhi also will tell. Ritu Sandhi means it's like a end of one season and the starting of another season.
Okay.
So in it's mentioned that the last 7 days of a season, a particular season ending and starting of another. So the 14 days, last seven and the starting seven of the other season, the 14 days we should take actually more care, because body is not easy to get adapted to the season change. So it will take time to adjust with the next season. So the Ritu Sandhi plays a major role. We have to take care more on this Ritu Sandhi.
Great. So presently, if I'm telling you so much.
Presently we are in actually Varsha Ritu. I can tell Varsha, that is monsoon.
Yeah.
So it's almost like July mid to September. It is almost like a Varsha Ritu only it is.
Right.
So here also, if I'm telling you like a, if just Varsha Ritu, I'm explaining means what it is mentioned in the classics. It's like rasa wise, if taste wise, if I'm telling that sour is the rasa of this particular season. And the Mahabhuta, if I'm telling, means it's like Prithvi and Agni is the dominant in this time. So if coming to a person, I'm telling means Vata Dosha will be more in this time.
Okay.
So Vata Dosha play is high and Pitta slowly started accumulating in your body. So overall our strength will be very less and digestive fire also will be less only. So we have to eat accordingly based on the digestive fire. So we having like if a diet regimen I'm telling means foods which is having sour, salty taste and a little oil quality like food we can take. So this help in this monsoon, like
during this
Varsha
season
Ritu,
and that is also okay for somebody like me whose pitta concentration is high, so that is okay.
It's okay means it's in a minimal, it's not like too much full fried items, like not like
right.
It's like in a minimal way, so just to get adjusted with the like the with the Ritu. So for that slightly we can use, it's not like a daily use or something. It's like like a weekly or alternately we can use, but it's not also, again, not in a too much quantity. In a less quantity, we can follow it. So that is also advice. And another thing is that try to take like medicated water or like at least boiled water, it should be taken. So that even usually now we also tell in general also will tell in rainy season we should have like warm water, because otherwise chance of getting in any infection or anything will be. And another thing mentioned is like a medicated gruel also. Medicated means different medicines we are making, putting and making a like a rice preparation, gruel preparation it is. So that also helpful in this condition, I mean this season. So recipe I'm not sharing, so we have to, if anyone want, we can share that, no issue with that.
Yeah, we can definitely do that. Very quickly, I have a question here. I know as we go along, I think if there are any questions that come to us online, we can pick it up. So Dazzle with Sush is asking, can a pitta person have lemon? No, I can
lemon.
Answer that.
Yeah.
Sorry.
It's actually so, but in a... Yeah, so this was a, actually lemon, one question came earlier also. Many people used to ask about whether lemon they can have or not, because coming to the sore and all, we are, so in a more, in a very less quantity, they can take it.
Okay.
In a very less, not daily, like in a, like, in like weekly or monthly, one or two times you are taking, no issue in that. It's not like a daily, we should not go for lemon. Even for lemon pickle or lemon juice or nothing, we should go in a regular way. Occasionally, we can take no issue.
Okay, got it.
So, coming to again back to our Varsha Ritu. So, in like activities like what is advice? So, it is like Abhyanga. So, Abhyanga is like Ayurveda, it's like Ayurvedic oil, that's medicated oil massage, it is full body oil massage. So, that's advised in this. And even Udvardhana. Udvardhana is like a powder massage. That is also advised in this season. But if people, it means we cannot go out and do also, if people, they can do self, like self abhyanga, self oil application home. So that is also helpful. So after that also, we should have bath in like warm water bath only we should take.
Okay.
Will, I mean, really help.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Rishikesh. Yeah. I mean, that's like, you know, I know it's a lot of information, but extremely, extremely informative. Thank you so much. Now, moving on,
and,
I know I'm just a little conscious about the time. Sorry, go on.
Time.
You have something else to say?
Okay. Yeah, one thing on. Is that, like, common, like common diseases during this time. So in like Varsha Ritu, common chances are like for the gastric related, diarrhea, dysentery, skin diseases, and like communicable diseases. So fever, these all are more common in this Varsha Ritu. So we have to be more aware on these things.
Okay. Great. I mean, thank you so much. Now, great. Moving on.
So
I
want
know
to,
you had some questions on Pilates, and I'm happy to answer those. Yeah.
Okay. So I understand that the Pilates for well-being, the first classical Pilates studies in India. So how does classical Pilates promotes holistic well-being?
Okay, now I'm sure you know what Pilates is. It's a low intensity exercise regime. Now, Pilates was designed to strengthen, lengthen, and restore a body's balance. Not so much like what people normally tend to make it out to be in India. They just say that Pilates is to build core, it improves flexibility, it improves strength. Yes, it does all of that, but mostly Pilates aims at uniform development of the body. So, and that is why it promotes holistic well-being. And apart from that, Pilates is a very instruction-driven practice. So meaning the client instructor or the student instructor interaction is very high. So a person needs to be mentally present when, you know, he or she is in a lesson or is being taught a private or a group. So it's not like, you know, you look at a person next to you or you're aping the instructor and you're learning the exercise. Because it's so instruction driven, a person's mental focus has to be extremely high. So, you know, taking on cues, because it's mental focus is, again, it's so much more about, you know, learning about their own body. And, you know, and it's just not while doing Pilates. So even, you know, when you're not doing Pilates, you carry Pilates in your body outside the studio also, like simple things like the way you sit, the way you stand, the way you walk. So we focus on all of those aspects. And then plus, regardless of one's age or mobility or fitness levels, Pilates is beneficial for everybody. And the reason why it is, it promotes holistic well-being is because people who practice Pilates on a regular basis experience a very heightened sense of awareness in their body and ease in their body. And this kind of, in the process helps with increased mobility, keeps a person pain-free, and the freedom that they experience in their bodies just improves one's quality of life.
Okay.
So it's just, as I said, it just does not focus on flexibility or strength building. So it's an amalgamation of all the good things that a person wants in his or her life to stay, energized and pain-free and healthy. That's what Pilates promotes. And that's why it is quite a, holistic and a well-being practice.
Okay. So based on that only, so how do you customize the movements according to the body type?
Okay, now I know, when it comes to customizing body movements, now typically, I'm just sorry, one second. Indra? Zach Nakutinpo, it's my dog. sorry. So just to answer that question now, typically when people enroll into a Pilates lesson, first of all, we do, sorry, one second. Yeah. I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
So when we kind of enroll people, so when people come in for a consultation, the first thing that we do is we get the client to kind of fill in a client intake form. That is to capture information about a client's background, the medical history of a client, the fitness, the levels of fitness they are currently in, the kind of exercise regimes that they have practiced in the past or currently practicing, if they have any injuries, etc. So we put that all down. It's more of a consultation just for us to understand as to what the requirements of a client are. And then when they start doing lessons with us, the first two or three lessons is more of an evaluation that we carry out to understand a person's muscular imbalances, what the strength levels are, what one's range of motion is, and what are the postural issues that he or she might have, how the feet placement is. So typically we understand a person's range of motion and abilities, and accordingly then the exercise regime is customized depending on what the need of the client is. So the practice is extremely adaptable and it is very, very versatile. And that's why, as I said, people of different age groups, different mobility levels, different range of motion, different backgrounds that they come in, everybody can safely practice Pilates. And that is why it is a very, very holistic practice. And it is not about, as I said, like people make it out to be that if we do Pilates, that we're going to get flexible, we're going to get strong. No, it is just not that. Yes, it is very, very individualistic because the practice is more about teaching a body than just teaching a certain exercise.
Okay.
So does that make sense, Dr. Rishikesh?
Yeah. Right. So actually,
I'm sorry. I was going to come to that because I know from Ayurveda, it's again, as you said, the doshas also contribute on an individual's body type. So you carry out that evaluation and that can also help with rehabilitation in Ayurveda. Is that correct?
Yes.
Right. Can you just talk to us a little about that, please?
Yeah, actually, I was telling that how you take the people. So based on that, if I'm telling means like body frame, Ayurveda will again the pragati wise, if I'm telling like body frame. So like Vata Pitta Kapha person, like Vata Pitta Kapha, in that usually Vata Pitta person will be always lean body, will be taller. And like prominent veins, everything will be on body. But Pitta will be always like average build and size, means like weight will be centered around the middle portion of the body. Mm-hmm. And coming to the Kapha person, he will be always little heavy, stocky.
Okay.
So either very tall or very short only, but will be strong, no visible vein thing. So it's like a body frame. And if we're coming to the body weight also, Vata person always will be in low weight, and Pitta will be in a medium, and
Okay.
Kapha person will be overweight people it will be.
Okay.
So
Okay.
and in actions also, if I'm telling the gait also, they will be always, Vata person will be always very quick, and the movements also will be very straight movements will be there. But person will be little more medium wise, it is medium speed movements. But Kapha person will be always slow, very slow, but
Okay.
it will be steady, they will be. Yeah. And
Okay.
their activity wise also, like they will be, every activity will be quick and very enthusiastic, like Vata person. Pitta
Okay.
will be always a little moderate and a little medium initiative. But Kapha person always slow, little like require more initiative, they need that. So like I was actually just classifying according to our priority also how it will come like.
Yeah. No, I think it's very interesting because, you know, a person's how you categorize a person's just not the physicality, but internally also via the doshas can actually help a person, you know, implement a certain exercise regime in their bodies. I think, you know, nothing like it. I'm sure that would work great. But as I said in Pilates, again, it's more about personal needs of a person, the issues that they're going through
that
we kind of address and we look into and we kind of carry out a detailed evaluation before we, you know, work with a client. Because again, we have to intake what a client's goal is, what the focus is, and accordingly work with him or her to be able to ensure that they reach their focus and goals eventually.
So do you get like a lot of clients with like injuries and lifestyle disorders too? How does like a like classical Pilates help them?
Yeah, definitely. Because Pilates as a movement practice, again, was introduced more from a rehabilitative or a rehabilitation perspective. So we work with a lot of clients with injuries. But sadly, what has happened is the way Pilates was promoted in India was not as a rehabilitative mechanism. It was more leaning onto the fitness side of it. It's only in the last 5 to 6 years that we have had to carry out, you know, a lot of, you know, education to people to, you know, understand what Pilates can actually do for them. You know, having said that, I would say that, oh, it's not a fitness regime. I wouldn't say that. It is a fitness regime because it is so much about keeping a person to move, you know, functionally so that, you know, injuries are avoided and they're able to understand all the imbalances in their body and correct them naturally as and how when they practice Pilates and be able to take it into different aspects of their lifestyle. So I would say from an injury perspective, yes, we deal with a lot of clients who require rehabilitation. But when coming to lifestyle disorders or diseases now, which is mostly due to unhealthy eating or, you know, lack of physical activity, or it could be, you know, excessive drinking or smoking or say even drug abuse. That is what lifestyle disorders normally come into play. We don't see a lot of clients from that perspective. But when people do have chronic conditions or chronic, you know, pains, that gives rise to other lifestyle diseases like diabetes or hypertension or any heart ailments or maybe even cancer. So that is when, you know, we kind of Pilates comes into place and we do see clients from that aspect.
Okay. That's
yeah.
Okay.
So does that answer your question, Dr. Rishikesh?
Yes, of course. Yeah.
Okay, great. Yeah. So then going on, I know we spoke about injuries, lifestyle disorders. Now, so typically if people want to, you know, check their doshas. Now, I know it is through a questionnaire that, you know, or a intake form that, you know, people answer their questions and, you know, then you categorize or classify them into, you know, dominant doshas in their bodies. Now, how accurate is this?
It's like a questionnaires are one part only. Actually, if a person coming directly, if a like a guest or patient is coming directly, we have to see their pulse also. Like, so through the nadi, we'll tell nadi pariksha. So comparing
Okay.
this both, we can come to a final conclusion. So both is
Okay.
factor in this. So we will get a we will get an idea, and seeing a
Okay.
person also we will get an idea. Like
Okay.
for a person coming for a consultation, by interacting with them also we will be getting some idea. Then seeing their
Okay.
pulse also we'll get some idea, and along with for more confirmation we'll go with the questionnaire also.
Or the questionnaire. Okay. Now, I mean, I know I answered the questionnaire because there are certain questions which, it is confusing because you don't know if you fall in that category or if you fall in this category or, what are you dominantly into? So, and I was pretty confused and I said, I mean, just based on the questionnaire, is it good enough data which is collated to determine a person's dosha or like a physical examination is better?
Physical
Now, I mean, I
examination.
know I
Yes.
haven't met you and you haven't checked my pulse, but you're seeing me, online. So do you think that I definitely would fall into a Pitta and a Vata category? I mean, just looking at me.
Yes, if I am telling means based on seeing and knowing the chart also, if I am telling means it's like Pitta is dominant, and next to that is the Vata.
Okay. Okay, great. I mean, I think, yeah, I mean, that kind of really helps. Okay, great. So maybe we do have some time to take on questions. So I know there were a few questions. So people, yeah, just send in your questions. I know we missed out a few. Now, there is somebody called Rainbow who says, how to handle
Yeah, for
sinus. So maybe this is a very
means
generalized question. So would you like to take that, Dr. Rishikesh?
so for the nasal congestion and the, like how to handle sinus. So again, more we have to know the details of that particular, more details we should come to know. But as general, I can tell means daily they can practice like at least 2 drops. So if medicated, I'm telling means we'll usually tell like Anutaila and all, that's medicated it is. If not
Yeah.
available, just at least 2 drops of til oil or just coconut oil, or at least ghee also. Fresh coconut means like cow ghee. Cow ghee also, that is also helpful in this. So daily they can put 2 drops. Along with that, daily they should take steam. That too with
Okay.
like water bone, with little turmeric and little tulsi leaves. So both putting
Okay.
and boiling the water at inhalation. So that will help
Okay.
relieve the congestion. And a daily
Okay.
practice of putting this oil in nose, so slowly, slowly that congestion frequency will come down.
Okay. Great. Thank you so much for answering that question. There's another question from Rohit Sarkar who's asking us, rather asking you, is Jeera water better to have if you have Pitta?
Yes, it is advised. He can take Jeera water.
Jeera water is advisable.
Yeah,
I
but
mean, is
only
that
thing
good
again,
to?
and only the temperature we have to take care in this. It should not be hot.
Okay.
It should be in a it should be very lukewarm.
Okay, so Jeera is like a cooling
Yes,
ingredient.
yes. Yes, of
And
course.
is it good to have that first thing in the morning, or how is that? You could have it throughout the day. How does that typically
Usually it
help,
is like
doctor?
in daily how many glass water they are taking, they can have that water only in a daily at least 3-4 cups, no issue in that, they can take it.
Okay. And Anjali has a question now. Is warm water good for digestion? Now, irrespective of what dosha that you fall into. Because again, as
Yeah.
I said, probably it's my misconception that I always think that, after a meal, it's always good to have, I mean, I typically have very hot water, which I definitely will stop doing so from today. But apart from that, is it good to have warm water for, for digestion?
Yes, of course. It's not. It's very helpful. But only thing is that it should not be taken immediately after food. At least little gap should be there. Then they can have it.
Okay. Okay.
But that
And
help really
I
helps
know.
in digestion.
Okay. And there are some beliefs that you have to drink at least about a glass or 2 glasses of water before a meal. How helpful is that?
If again, if I am telling Ayurvedic way, if we are following, we'll tell that along with the diet also, little, it's not like too much water, like sip, 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 just to make the food what we are eating to make little liquefy. So little sip by sip we should take. It's not full one glass of water. It's like sip, sip, sip we should take. So before also, just immediately after the, before the lunch or dinner we are having, then that will make our like Agni weak only. So that time they will feel that, okay, I will have less food only. It's okay. It's having less food. It's no issue. But still, water is making the Agni down. So that's not that right according to our like digestive tract. So little, little we can sip water and have it during having, while having food also, and after also only little, little water, not too much water.
Okay, great. I have one more question for you, Dr. Rishikesh. Now, once a person knows what his or her predominant dosha is, so and eating, you know, complying with the Ayurvedic type of eating, you know, is that something that a person can or opt to do on a continued basis to, you know, ensure that he or she stays healthy? Because sometimes what happens is when we get into some kind of an eating regime, after a point in time, people tend to lose focus. People tend to lose consistency. Yeah. So how does one actually keep up to that? Is that something that, you know, that people would naturally start seeing those, you know, positive changes in their body, and that itself is a good enough reason for them to continue it for the rest of their lives?
Yes. So it's like they should start doing and see the changes. So then only they will have the feel, okay, some changes I'm feeling. Without that, if we are simply telling, people may ignore, okay, it's nothing like that, okay, if I am having this also. But when we thoroughly follow according to our doshas, really that changes, we can feel it. Really that will be, that changes, we, it is visible for us.
Okay,
In our body, that changes will be there, yeah.
Okay, and I know there are a lot of, you know, like, you know, panchakarma, for example, detoxification of a body using oils, etc., and plus using a lot of Ayurvedic medicines. Now, when you're eating as per your doshas, is it important to go through the panchakarma practice as well?
Yes. So just one example. So how a car we will be maintaining. So all in between, we will be doing servicing for that. So same like our body also need a service. So it's like internal cleansing. So it is like a clearing the what is getting base, getting accumulated. Because whatever we are having, we cannot tell that all are like pure items we are having. So vegetables, it's like there also pesticides will be there. So this all little, little will be getting, toxins will be getting accumulated in our body. So one detox, like Pancharma, if I'm telling Pancharma, that is comes under a Shodhana procedure. So Shodhana, it is advised. Every year, at least once, we are giving a shodhana for our body. It's like cleansing ourselves, servicing our body.
Okay, so does that mean that detoxification or panchakarma can be done once a year, or does it have to be done frequently?
No, once a year. Once a year, it is recommended. If we are going with a proper panchakarma, if like a panchakarma procedure, panchakarma, usually people will get confused that what panchakarma and other treatments. Usually panchakarma, it is like five things only. It is like Vamana, Virajana, Vasti. Vasti also two types, Astavana, Anuvasana, two types of Vasti and Nasya. Those, these five are called only as Panchakarmas. But people will like Shirodhara, then Abhyanga, then everything will be classified under Panchakarma only. So this procedure, like these five are called as the Shodhana procedures. So these five Shodhana procedures we are following means that yearly once only it is needed for the body.
Okay, great. Yeah. I mean, I think that was a very, very, you know, great and an informative session, Dr. Rishikesh. Thank you so much. And for all of those who have joined us today, if you have any questions, feel free to write that on and we will post them up as stories. And if you all want to check what your doshas are, then you can get onto Nad's page and, you know, get in touch with Nad directly and Dr. Rishikesh. They also do carry out complimentary consultations. So try it out. I mean, it's something that you can try out if you never have. And then great. I mean, I would really thank you for joining us today, Dr. Rishikesh. And thanks.
Thank you for you also, because I also Yeah, many information I got from you too. Yeah,
Yeah,
regarding
no, very,
phalanges.
very informative. And I'm sure our viewers today have enjoyed it. And then we'll post this video on IGTV, so those of you who have either joined us late or missed joining us can always go back there and view. And plus, do look out what we have coming up next weekend. We keep bringing you good well-being topics. That's what we all want to strive and work towards currently. And great, and have a lovely evening. And thanks again, Dr. Rishikesh.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, bye-bye.